Our next guest first hit our screens at the tender age of 22 as part of the original cast of The Only Way Is Essex. Bearing her soul on the reality show and in the press, fans thought they knew everything about her life until last Christmas when she ended up hospitalised with a secret health condition. And she joins us now to talk about her battle with anxiety. Thanks so much for talking to us, Lauren. It's great to see you.
Hello.
We're talking about this hospital time at Christmas. What exactly happened? What triggered this episode?
Well, I suffer with anxiety, which is kind of a new thing that I've formed over the years. We're obviously not born with anxiety, but I think the pressure of like coming into fame, other pressures that I've been through in life, it literally is it's a feeling that feels so real, like you're dying, but it's not a real thing. And actually, last Christmas, obviously Christmas is quite a stressful time. I had everyone at my house. There was like a massive party. I woke up the next day and I think where the day was kind of over, it just all hit me at once. And I literally felt like I was having a heart attack. That is the only thing I can kind of explain how anxiety feels. It feels like you're dying. And all I could think, I literally collapsed to the floor and I was like, I couldn't breathe. I just couldn't move. My heart was racing. So I literally just called an ambulance and they stayed with me. Obviously, because they always do like proper checks and stuff. So they took me to the hospital, kept me in, offered me a diazepam, just said, you just got an anxiety, you're fine. But anxiety feels like the worst feeling ever. It doesn't feel like it's just an emotion. It feels like a real feeling. It is awful.
Is that the worst attack that you've had of it, Lauren?
I think so. I first had a panic attack on an aeroplane. It was something there was headlines everywhere about something at the time. And I experienced this thing for the first time ever. And I was like, what is going on? And it's kind of like stopped and started over the years, like the last, I'd say 8 years. And then this kind of hit me this year quite bad. But yeah, I just kind of have to recognise what it is and that you're not going to die.
I mean,
Gloria, just to ask you,
I mean, as far as I'm concerned, you got most of your fame coming from The Only Way Is Essex, etc. Mm-hmm. Do you think exposing your life on TV, etc., has brought on your anxiety, made it all worse, and do you regret exposing all on TV as such?
I don't regret it because as much as, yes, it is hard, there's dark times, you know, you obviously go through a lot of different emotions. I was young, you know, when I first met the producers when I was 21, you didn't really understand it all the time. It was the first reality show. I've grew up on telly. I'm on the headlines all the time. And that can be hard. And, you know, that is what can be difficult for me. And I feel like with my upbringing and my family situation, I'm a very strong character, but I'm also human. And I feel like when I take on a lot of things at once, that is when I have an anxiety attack. And I feel like we're just programmed, like, you know, if it was a computer, you would explode at some point. And that is how I try and explain it to myself, like it's not real. I don't regret doing TOWIE. You know, I've got a lot of love for the show. It's where I started. This is my career now, and I don't really know any different.
Mm. I mean, it's interesting, Lauren, because I've got daughters and, you know, all the reports about sort of social media and online activity is pointing to younger women feeling more anxious because of social media.
100%.
So have you ever thought about just, I mean, it sounds daft, but just sort of like coming off social media and just going to work on a farm or something and see whether or not that would make a difference.
Yes, and you know what's really funny? This is why I do aesthetics and I do other things that connect me to the real world and make me feel alive. So as much as people might say you're doing aesthetics, like I do all the beauty stuff, because that is my background. When I left school, I went into beauty and that is what I enjoy. So I do miss having a regular job as well. So that's why I kind of do the aesthetic side of it as well as the TV side, because it makes me feel normal.
Now, Lauren, you're going to have to forgive me. You have to forgive my age, because you know this organisation or this platform of OnlyFans, where people pay you money and you send them very racy photographs, not just you, but lots of people, I suppose. But why would you do that?
Okay, so OnlyFans was originally started by a guy in Essex and it was meant for celebrities talking to fans, like how we are now. It was then bought by an American company and they thought, you know, all these girls are putting up these sexy pictures on Instagram for free. Why not sell them? And they've tried to get me for 2 years. And I was like, no, I'm not doing it. It sounds horrendous. I'm not like that. And I judged it. But you can never judge a girl by their Instagram. And I feel like I post these pictures anyway on Instagram. So why not do it? And people can buy them. And it's been amazing. I don't regret it at all. But I don't do nude. I don't do anything naked.
What does your family say about that, though? Because I think it's only like one nats away from pornographic photographs.
No. It's literally like I kind of post sexy stuff anyway. So it's kind of like just underwear. I don't do nipple. I don't do naked. I don't do anything like that. Because also I don't want it to be screenshotted and etc. So I still want, you know, to get married and not people judge me and whatever. So I just do sexy pictures, but it's kind of more, it's like a more intimate thing that you can talk to fans. Sometimes they just want to DM you, like they do on Instagram anyway. So I'm having a great time on it, but I don't do anything sexy or anything to jeopardise anything, if that makes sense. Mm.
You know, Lauren, obviously you're known for being in TOWIE and they had their 10-year anniversary, but you didn't attend.
Yes.
Why did you feel like you
actually available that day. And in my defence, because it was more, I think, people currently on the show, I think most of the cast that was there are still on the show. So there was a few that went back and I have a lot of love for it. But I feel like it's kind of, I've been there and I've done it and they showed the scenes. But I did put a love shout out on my Instagram. So I did support them and I always will.
Lauren, where does it sort of sit in your heart as such now, TOWIE? Because we were all amazed by the success of it. I remember the first episode and not being sure what it was. Is this real? Is this a documentary? And then it took over everybody's lives for those 10 years. Where does it sort of sit with you now? Do you have fond memories of it? Or do you have any regrets at all?
It's like, obviously, it's where I started. Like, I'll have a lot of love for it always. It was strange. It was weird. There was no other reality shows about. So it was a bit of a weird thing. We kind of put on these screens. You had press following you around. Everyone wants to talk about you. Everyone wants to know you. And it hasn't changed for me for the last 10 years, which is mad. Because I left the show, 8 years ago, 7 years ago? But I'm still very current, which I'm grateful for. Because as much as it is hard, difficult, there's also a lot of beautiful things out of it. And I've experienced such amazing things that I wouldn't have done without it. So, you know, I don't regret doing it at all. And it holds some special memories for me also.
Mm-hmm. And I guess just to feel like it's very much in the past, so to go back is just not something you'd really think of.
I don't know right now. I feel like I've done it and I would never knock it and say that I would never go back. But I feel like when we done it, it was very much around my life, my relationship, my friendships.
It's such a personal thing, isn't it? Yeah.
No one can say they've won a BAFTA. So,
Lauren, thank you. Lauren, I'm going to have to stop you. Thank you. Take care of yourself. Thank you so much for talking to us. Thank you.